couple weeks ago I got this camcorder at the thrift store. It's a Sharp Slimcam full-size VHS camcorder from 1996. Probably one of the later ones they ever made. I did have one just like this, and I did a video about it a couple years ago. That one was from 1994, but it was basically the same thing, same design. You can see it got the name Slimcam because it's very slim for a full-size VHS camcorder. It's also pretty light, and the viewfinder folds away like that when you're not using it, so it's nice and compact. This one actually has the foam still good on the microphone, which is usually not the case, so this one is in very good condition. There is the external microphone jack. Otherwise, it's pretty basic for a full-size VHS camcorder. Has 12 times optical zoom, autofocus, black and white viewfinder. There's where the battery goes on. There's a jack for the DC power supply. It says DC 6 volts. I didn't get the power supply with it, but I do have one that does work with it. Has a handle on the top, accessory shoe. On the front, you get a lens cap. And the lens does have a thread on it for adding a filter. There's the recording tally light, which blinks red when it's recording, which is a nice feature to have because most cameras these days don't have a light on them telling you when it's recording. And there are some other controls for the manual focus and fader, backlight compensation, and the full automatic switch. It has a bunch of controls for the tape playback and recording, audio dubbing, counter reset and display, and there's the main power switch. There's the zoom lever and the recording button. And on the bottom is just a tripod mount. I also got the original battery charger and battery. I don't have any hopes of this battery actually working. It measures about 3.7 volts and it's supposed to be 6 volts. So I don't know if it'll be able to be revived. And there's the original battery charger. Puts out 6.8 volts at 2.4 amps. On my other channel I have a test video I made using the 1994 Slimcam I had, which will be pretty much exactly the same performance and video quality as this one. So if you want to see what the video looks like from one of these, just look at that video, which I'll put a link to in the description. One thing of note is the one lux minimum illumination. So these camcorders do very well in low light. And if you take off this door, you can see the video input and output jacks and a remote jack. So it probably did come with a wired remote, which would probably just be the start stop for recording. Maybe the zoom. I don't know if they were able to do that. And then we have this one, which I just got today, and this one is a little bit different and a little bit special. Because I noticed right away when I first saw it, twin slim cam, and then super wide angle picture in picture. And I saw this 12x twin lens system. If you look at the front, it does have two lenses. A big one and a small one, so it can do picture in picture between the two lenses, or you can switch back and forth between them. As typical, the foam is missing around the microphone, so this one is not in mint condition like the 1996 one is. This one's from 1992. One difference is that the handle can sort of fold up on this one, whereas on the newer one it's just a molded piece of plastic. And unfortunately this one has some electronic problems, probably due to bad capacitors. As you can see, the video output is not very stable, and I had to aim it in a very specific location just to get it to be that good. Right now it's in super wide mode. Maybe we'll just see on the viewfinder. See there, it says super wide. It's kind of funny, the image in the viewfinder is fine, but the image on the monitor keeps flipping out. Could be just because it's a flat panel TV and those are sometimes a little more fussy about the quality of the video signal they're getting. What I'm going to try to do, see there's picture in picture, and you can move it around the screen with this button here, move, So it's kind of a gimmick because it's both lenses are aiming in the same direction, of course. So there's not much difference except the small one is just a very zoomed in version of the big image. And if you hit the button here, it's going to freak out, but what that does is it switches between the two lenses. Maybe it'll be better on the viewfinder. See, that's the wide angle lens. Then if we hit the button, we get the zoomed up lens. And the wide angle one is the little one on the top. As you can see, I'm covering up the big one and you don't see my fingers on the screen. But if I move my fingers to cover up the little one, then it blocks off that one. It's kind of funny, if I block off some of the light, then it works fine if I let go. So let me try switching to the close-up lens. Does the same thing. If I cover it up a little bit, it becomes more stable. So the close-up lens is the big one, and if we switch over to the wide-angle lens, that's the small one. And it is wide-angle. You can see a slight curvature to the image, just like that Sony HD camcorder I reviewed on my other channel. Sort of a fisheye effect. So in the early 90s, picture-in-picture televisions were very popular. Big attraction for them was the ability to watch one channel on the main screen and then have a smaller picture in the corner of another channel, so the TV would have two tuners in it and you can switch back and forth, similar to how this has the two lenses. So I guess this was Sharp's attempt to capitalize on that market at the time and develop a twin lens picture-in-picture camcorder, something I haven't really seen done since then. Probably because it was mostly just a gimmick and nobody really used it that much. But unfortunately this one has some problems, and when I first turned it on I didn't think it would work at all, because all I got was a very fuzzy and faint black and white image, and for the first half hour or so all I could get out of it was black and white, and then the color started coming in. So it looks like the capacitors did reform slightly, but it still has problems and it's still kind of freaks out when you first turn it on. See, they're sort of coming on slowly, and the picture-in-picture thing is kind of freaking out. I don't know if the tape mechanism works, I haven't tried it, but at least it does eject. So you can see all the gears and pulleys and belts and stuff in there. Here's the one from 1996, and this one works perfectly. A nice image in the viewfinder and on the TV screen, and you can see the zoom. The funny thing it does is if you zoom in too far and it can't focus right, it automatically zooms out. I'm not touching the button, it's automatically zooming out. Also, if you aim it at a scene without enough light, it says light in the viewfinder to warn you. You see, it goes away if I take my fingers off the lens. So, that's one thing Sharp camcorders always did. They give you a warning when there's not enough light. And it does produce a very nice image. In fact, let me turn off my lights here. And that's the normal image, and if I hit gain up, you can see it gets slightly brighter, but also more grainy. And that's just with the 60 watt light bulb up there. It's the only illumination on this side. So here's what my Canon FS200 sees, and here's what the Sharp sees. So you can see all of the detail. I mean, it's grainy, but you can see the detail of those speakers behind the Apple mousepad and the stereo system. On this one, it's not as good. So it does do very well in low light. And here on the regular Slimcam from 1996, you can see it has the knockout plug, where the picture-in-picture version had the button to switch between the two lenses. I couldn't really find any information online about the twin Slimcam, other than a newspaper article from when it was first introduced in 1992, which said the Slimcam was the lightest full-size VHS camcorder on the market at the time at 3.5 pounds, And that Sharp also had a 8mm picture-in-picture camcorder, because in the 90s, Sharp was most well known for their 8mm view cam camcorders, where the lens pivoted separately from the tape and LCD housing. So they also had a picture-in-picture twin lens version of one of those camcorders as well.